I'll try. Let's see if I can draw a circle.
Refresher on that circle.
Refresher on the circle. So we start. We start in the middle. I go counterclockwise.
Hey.
Now.
Woo!
So I also start with when I've, again, when I'm in those conversations with people and they're asking me, what do you believe and why? What does it mean to be a Christian? Even the question, why do you go to church? I even have turned that one to this. And so the reason I go to church is because church connects me to a much bigger purpose and story in the world. Because I only share that with them. And so I always somehow get back to this if I can. But it all starts with the world. You know, there's a lot of beauty in our world. I say, you know, like we look at our world, there's a lot of great, beautiful stuff in our world. My kids are beautiful, the sunrise is beautiful, there's a lot of beauty in the world, but there's also a lot of brokenness. I'll start with brokenness. Say, there's a lot of brokenness in our world, stuff that we look at when we turn on the news that just rends on our hearts. What is that for you? What are some of the things that really just break your heart? People list off all different kinds of things, right? I'll put up a couple of the other ones again. Disease. So let's stick with D's. Divorce. It's getting harder. Death. Aha. Death. Thank you. That's a fun one. Who said disasters? Disasters. Thank you. Disasters. I've actually got that. What does God have to say about natural disasters? I'm not going to stick with D's anymore. Emptiness. It's a combination. Poverty. Yeah, there's a lot of brokenness in our world. There's a lot of stuff that when we look at our world, we have this internal gut feeling like that's not right. That's not the way the world is supposed to be. And that instinct is correct. That's not the way the world is supposed to be. See, at the heart of the Christian faith is a story. It's a story about a God who made this world out of his deep love for it. That when God created everything, if you were to go to the beginning of the Bible and see how this whole thing got started, what you see is the constant refrain in the story is God made the world good. Over and over again, he makes the created order and the universe and the stars and the planets, our environments and nature, good and beautiful, working perfectly and harmoniously. Furthermore, at the pinnacle of that creation, God made human beings in his image. And our job as human beings was to live in loving relationship with our God and Creator, and to live in loving relationship with each other and the world that he made. It says that we are actually made in his image. That means that we were made to love the world that he made, to live in loving relationship with him, with each other, and to steward and to take care of this world that he placed us in. If you can imagine that, just imagine a world where none of this stuff exists, and in its place are things like love, and there's no disease, there's no death, there's no disasters even. I mean, can you imagine a created order without hurricanes? That was the world that God made. It was beautiful and it was good. So how did we get here? The answer, we believe as Christians, is that we basically rebelled against God. That even though he made the world and he made it perfect and he had his purposes and his plans for it, we decided we don't like your plans. We want to do things our own way, and so we rebelled against God. We cut off our relationship with him. But the problem is when you cut yourself off from the author of life, the rest of the created order that he made spirals into chaos. And all this stuff, because of our rebellion, is a symptom of that rebellion against our good and perfect creator. Our rebellion led to the downfall of our world. It broke our relationship with God, with the world, with our relationship with the world that he made, and our relationships with each other. And the question is what is God going to do about that? I mean, God made all this stuff. He made us to be in relationship with him. What is he going to do? I mean, he has every right to kind of leave us to our own devices and say, well, to hell with them. But what we believe is God didn't do that. And while God is the creator and the Lord over creation, he's also our Father. And it's out of his fatherly goodness and love that he enters the world in Jesus Christ. And what's amazing about Jesus is that everywhere that Jesus goes, he actually started to show people what life lived in relationship with their good and loving creator actually looks like. He calls this the kingdom of God. He says, this is what it's like to live under God's perfect, good, and loving reign, which is why everywhere that Jesus went, he started to turn back the symptoms of our rebellion. Okay? So where there was like divorce and broken relationships, Jesus brought love. Where there was emptiness, he talked about fullness. Fullness in living life with God and in the purposes that he made you for. Where there was disease, he brought healing. Where there was poverty, he talked about abundance. Generosity. Where there were disasters, he actually calms the storms. I mean, that's just pretty amazing. Even the environment and nature responds to him as he calms the storms. And ultimately, where there's death, Jesus brings life. Jesus says, this is the way God intended it all to be. You can have that relationship with him. But we have to remember that all this brokenness that we see, these are simply symptoms of the deeper problem, which is our rebellion against our good and perfect Creator. This is what we call sin. Sin is not simply that we've broken a couple of random rules that God laid out. It's actually our internal rebellion against the one who made us. And the question is, how is God going to punish that rebellion and still forgive his children? And Jesus has an answer for that too. Jesus says, I'm willing to bear the punishment on my own shoulders. That he was willing to go to a cross to die for his wayward creation so that they might be saved from punishment, that they might enter into a renewed and forgiven relationship with the one who made them, with his Father in heaven. But more than that, Jesus actually rises again from the dead and he says, now you know that I have victory over sin. And one day, I'm going to come again, and when I do, I'm going to bring that kingdom of God in its fullness, and there will no longer be all this brokenness like disease and death and disasters, poverty, emptiness, and broken relationships. Creation will be restored to the good, beautiful, perfect creation that God always intended to be, and we will live in relationship with him and with each other for all time. But in the meantime, in the in-between time, you, my people, are now sent out with a purpose. And that is to be ambassadors of that kingdom. To bring that good news of healing, forgiveness, reconciliation to a broken world. This is what it actually means to be a Christian, to be the church. That we're God's family on mission with him, sent out to heal a broken world. That's essentially what we believe in a nutshell. So what questions do you have about that? Unless they're already starting to ask questions, which sometimes happens. So there you go. That's my circle again, little diagram.